Hello, Sunday, July 25th, 2021. It's going to be another hot day here in the Kootenays and smoke-filled. Fire's burning pretty much in all directions, but we're safe here for now. Fires are far enough away, no wind, and no rain showing up. So early in the morning here, we're going to finish up with a couple of projects. Already, well, pretty much finished up with both of them here. So what we got going on here was the old Case D tractor. Finally got around to finishing up with the charging system here because it's just handier. You don't have to charge a goddamn battery every time you want to use it. So what I did right off the hop is I put a brand new battery in it, realized that's what the problem was that I had last fall. It would just overcharge itself. So brand new battery, working really good. I put a new amp gauge up there that goes up to 50 amps, either negative or positive. Starts and runs really good. Finally got all the four tires on this old girl. Had a problem with, I put oversized tires on the front, raised up the blades so the hydraulics are a little short. It would only go down to within an inch of the ground, which proved not to be the best scenario. So I just quickly added an inch to the boss here, raised her up, or inch, more than an inch, probably two and a half inches. So it actually pushes down on the ground. Last thing here going on, well, I still got to work up the wiring here. That's kind of a mishmash of whatever work for now wiring, brand new alternator. But everything is working good. I got the final tire put on here a little while ago, and I had said that the lock ring was so badly deteriorated in a couple of places that I would weld it, of which I just did. Here you can see that the ring is rotted away there, so at either side of the major rot, I put a little bead of welding there just to hold the darn thing in place. And same as on the joint here, either end of it. I tagged it together. It's not going to do a lot of work in its rest of its life. Knocking around the place here the odd time. I have been using it to pull this D4 around. Push and pull it. We got this thing almost, all finished up at the rear end here. I had to take all these components off the seat and the tank and the fenders and maybe see in there, but there's a lid that goes across the whole rear end and differential in there. I had to pull that off and get in there, clean everything right out. The steering clutches were froze, so I had to pull them all apart, back together, put back together, and so that's all done. Now the next plan of attack here is working at the pony motor. It doesn't want to start, so I think I'm going to have to pull it apart. I did a compression check on it. 10 pounds or 15 pounds on each cylinder, not enough to really run. So I'm going to pull it apart and see what we can do with some rings and pistons in there. Anyway, that's what the progress is on the old farm here today. And we're going to call it a day. I think I'm going to get on the motorcycle and go for a little ride here this afternoon. A little bit warm over here. No use working in the sun. Catch up to you later.